In the females, a particular hormone called as follicle stimulating hormone, FSH, will be playing a very important role in the production or the or during the process of ovulation. During the process of ovulation, this particular hormone is playing a very important role. What is that hormone called? Follicle stimulating hormone. So from where this hormone is coming? It is coming from the pituitary gland. The anterior part of the pituitary gland releases the follicle stimulating hormone. Then only this, the production of ova will be happening in the females. So as in the name itself, we have just discussed, I have discussed about this fallopian tubule. The fallopian tubule contraction and relaxation, it all depends upon the release of this particular hormone called as follicle stimulating hormone. As I told you just now, the how this ovary, what is happening inside this ovary and what are the different cycles that are formed inside and what is the exact position of ovulation and how the egg is coming from the ovary into the infundibulum and finally lodging into the ampulla or the fundus regions. Now let us see, this is the correct structure, or you can see a very clear picture of the TS of the ovary, that is the transverse section of the ovary. As you can see, this is somewhat oblong shape or leaf-like structure, and you can see that here when I talked about, see the outermost layer, just like in our previous class we have seen how it is for the testes, same like that here also in the ovary, the outermost layer, the cells are scattered outermost layer, which we call it as the germinal epithelium, and these are forming the germ cells which are essential for the development of the female gametes. Understood? So this is what is called as this germinal layer. The germinal layer is the outermost region. Now you can see that a hand-like structure which is connecting, this is called as ovarian ligament. I told you, know, in the previous diagram, see this was something like this. I told you that here will be the ovary and here it is the connection. So this is nothing but this ovarian ligament. Now what are these primordial follicles? You can see the inside the ovary that some follicles will be formed like this with one cell, one nucleus or single cellular cells, which we call it as the primordial follicles. Now what is happening? These are forming, these particular primordial follicles are forming into the next levels. They are called as the primary follicles. That means primordial follicles are giving rise to the primary follicles. This is called as the primary follicle. What is the function of this primary follicle? During certain cell divisions, only the number of chromosomes which are present here, it is 2N, that is always diploid in conditions. There are 2N number of chromosomes in the primary follicles. This primary follicle, after attaining to some stage, some growth inside, it will be forming the secondary follicle. It will be forming the secondary follicle. In presence of FSH hormone, that means the follicle stimulating hormone will be playing a very vital role in this particular reaction. Okay. The primary follicles has to grow into secondary follicles only in the presence of follicle stimulating hormone, which we are getting from the pituitary gland. Okay. Next, secondary follicle is developing into tertiary follicle. This is the tertiary follicle where everything is happening inside the ovary. Okay. So tertiary follicle, you can see The secondary follicle immediately changes into the tertiary follicle, and this is the tertiary follicle. When you take this tertiary follicle outside and you see, it looks like this. Can you see this space which is completely white in color? This is called as the antrum. What is antrum? Antrum is that part in the tertiary follicle which is providing nourishment to the egg. Okay, the nourishment is being supplied to the egg in the form of antrum. Next is the oocyte. You can see oocyte is the innermost cell. Every time I am putting these dots, these are all the oocytes. So, this is the oocyte and this is the antrum which is supplying the food materials to the oocyte. And inside the oocyte, you can see a dark spot-like structure which we call it as zona pellucida. This is the zona pellucida. This is nothing but during the formation of oogenesis, as I told you in my previous classes, this will be forming the different types of follicles during the puberty of the female. Okay. Now, you can see the outermost region of this particular tertiary follicle. This is called as theca folliculi. Actually, the theca externa and theca interna are the two layers which are present in the oocytes. The theca externa is the outermost layer and theca interna is the innermost layer. Okay, what is the function of all these things? I will tell you. Just remember that these are the two layers which are surrounding these follicles. Now, what happens is after the formation of tertiary follicles, please come back here. The tertiary follicles immediately after many divisions, and all these reactions will happen only in the presence of FSH. If follicle stimulating hormone is not activating, the oogenesis will not occur. Egg will not be released. Today we see in many cases in today's world that many females are suffering with lots and lots of hormonal diseases. So what is the main thing is if the anterior gland of the pituitary is not secreting follicle stimulating hormone, egg will not be released. So now come back. Those are all the exceptional cases. Now, when this tertiary follicle is formed here like this, okay, what it is happening immediately in the next stage, this tertiary follicle will form into the bigger type of the cell, and that is where you can see the oocyte will be grown bigger when compared to the tertiary and also secondary follicles. Here you can see the oocyte. Can you see here clearly? Ovulated oocyte. Ovulated oocyte, that too with corona radiata. If you take this outside and see, the corona radiata will be something like this. This is called as the corona or corona radiata. Why I am talking so much about this? Because it has a lot of role during the process of fertilization. Okay, what is that? I'll tell you when I discuss about the fertilization. Now just remember that the tertiary follicles, after some divisions, it will be forming into a bigger cell which is called as the ovulated oocyte, which will be surrounded with the corona radiata. Understood? Now, immediately after this development, what will happen here? It will changes into, in presence of LH, that is luteinizing hormone, another important hormone which is again releasing from the anterior region of the pituitary gland, we call it as a luteinizing hormone. LH hormone is playing a very important role in the production of this particular larger formation of the egg. Larger formation of the egg here, ultimately it comes like this. and this we call it as corpus luteum. We call it as corpus luteum. So corpus luteum will be formed only in the presence of luteinizing hormone, and if fertilization occurs at this stage, if fertilization occurs, what is meant by fertilization? The union of the male gamete with the female gamete to form the zygote, to form the zygote is called as fertilization. Okay, so when fertilization occurs, then what happens? Corpus luteum, in presence of another important hormone called as progesterone, will be helping in the maintenance of pregnancy. Okay, will be helping in the maintenance of pregnancy. You can remember like this: progesterone hormone, P for pregnancy. So like that you can remember, which is very important. And the progesterone hormone helps in the maintenance of pregnancy if fertilization occurs. If fertilization does not occur, what is the next step? So if fertilization does not occur, this immediately it forms into, in presence of luteinizing hormone, again LH only, it is forming, or it is, the egg has been released. Okay, it will be released and it will be traveling again, like I told you, know, it will be coming out and traveling through this particular fallopian tubule, and here it will be lodging. And if a fertilization will not occur through the endometrium of this particular uterus, the uterine bleeding will occur, and hence